Hi everybody, this is Vineet. I'm the founder of TeliportMe, and if you have joined our program or a broader product, you would have seen me on your welcome emails. One of the biggest questions I get is what kind of camera that needs to be used. There is a video that I've created on YouTube with one of the biggest influencers in this category. And he breaks down the different segments and he provides a range of products that someone can buy from. If you're a customer of ours, you get discounts. You just have to click on some links. It's there in the dashboard and you can buy your cameras at a I think like 20% off at the minimum and the maximum about 30% off. So it's a great deal. If you can't find the link, send me an email. I'll get back to you. This is Vineet at teleportme.com. But to just kind of reiterate, capturing panoramas and creating the virtual tours is an art, and you have to spend some time learning how to do it. It's like any kind of photography. You have to spend some time to learn the tools. So to start off with, you can use your mobile phone, so it can be Android or iOS. There are three kinds of panoramas to start off with. One is the cylindrical panorama. A cylindrical panorama does not have the up and the top. Sorry, the up and the bottom. And what this means is that you cannot really have the top view and the bottom view in the virtual tour. Now, a lot of customers that use our virtual tours, especially small businesses, have no problem with this. But you know, real estate, realtors, they're a little bit demanding, and so they prefer the up and down. Today, in the App Store, both Google and iOS, there's only one app that captures the top and down, but it is not really good indoors. So even if you get the app and it's a free app, it's a Google Street View app, it will create really, really bad panoramas inside apartments. Cylindrical panoramas also are not that great inside an apartment or a house or a smaller space. It's okay when it's a slightly larger area, but inside the house, it's not that great. All right, so I think the real question that everybody has is, what do I recommend? What I recommend is to invest in a 360 camera. Now, if you have bought the product with us, either through a deal or directly a subscription, our upfront cost is really low. So you don't really have to worry about our cost of our software because you would make that money with one client that you get. Right? So a 360 camera, that the one that I have here, is what I recommend generally to start off with. It is a Theta SC2. I recommend the Theta a lot because the Theta's top quality products are the best in the market. And the ones that are, you know, kind of what professional virtual tour photographers use. And that's about $1,000. This is about $250. But if you learn how to take great panoramas with this, the workflow is really similar. So you can easily scale. You don't have to learn anything new. And so I would recommend either getting this one, a new one, or getting a secondhand one to start off with. So you can get a 360 camera for anywhere between $200 to $250, $300. I recommend the Theta SC2. Definitely buy one. It's totally worth it. You put in a total of about $350 to start this business, start this as a new service line, and you could make that money in your first customer itself. So that is my recommendation to everybody, is to get a Theta as your first device. Now, if you already have another device, that's great. Don't worry about it. Most devices are the same. It is only because of the price and the workflow that I recommend the Theta. Theta is also very compatible with our app, our 360 app that you can use. Speaking of our app, a lot of people are asking us this question too, is because we have a paid application. Yes, you can use our paid application as a way to capture panoramas, connect your Theta to the app and connect it and then upload them directly using your app. But you need to log into your AppSumo or your TeliportMe account. So it does not automatically detect that you have already paid. So you have to log in. And once you log in, it will detect that you are a business user or a you know, not a free user, and it will enable your priority that way. And so this way you can access all the features, the HD features, the capture features, the shared WhatsApp, shared to Instagram features on our app, which I think are really cool. And then we have also Tiny Planet. So the sort of the TLDR or the baseline is you can start off with a free 360 app, but it is not a professional service that you can provide. To provide a professional service, you need to invest in a 360 camera. The 360 camera that we recommend is the Theta SC2. It is about $250, depending on the country. It could go up and down. I think some countries it's about $300. That is an investment which I think I'm comfortable recommending. And you would need a little bit of photo editing understanding to get it, and then our software will do all the magic. Once you are a little bit better, once you understand how it works, once you have a couple of clients, you can invest in a Theta Z1 or a X Phase. These are high-end cameras. They are about $1,000 or an $800 camera. I don't recommend that at the first go, because you really don't know how your market is going to be, how your market is going to respond, how long it's going to take for you to get your money back. But I can definitely say that buying one 360 camera at a $300 range and our software will get you back your money in your first sale. So that's my recommendation. If you have any questions, definitely feel free to email me at vineet@teleportme.com. And I'm happy to answer all questions that you have. I'm excited to have you guys on our journey. You know, one of the things I really enjoy is seeing people start their virtual tour businesses. We already have 4 people that bought our product last week or the week before it, and they already got their first client, which is great. So I look forward to seeing all you guys have successful businesses. All right, take care. Bye-bye.